IoT-based water quality monitoring system. For operating this project, we need to set the hotspot now. Just go to settings, mobile settings, portable hotspot, set up portable hotspot. Here, you need to set the SSID as IoT2K19010. All the letters should be small. You just copy this and paste it as a password. Set the mode as security mode as WP, this one. Then paste the same as password. First letter of I should be small. Everything should be as same as it is. Just give OK. Portable hotspot. We enable the portable hotspot now. Once it is done, you have to switch on your mobile data. Now see, here there is an indication called no connected device. Okay, that means no device is connected yet. I will show you. Before operating the kit, we need to set something in your mobile. So like this. Now it is okay for this. Then open the application, IoT application. In this IoT application, you have to paste the same user ID and same password. Before that, just once installing this application, just go to settings, in search option type permission. In this permission option, here go to permissions. In this, you need to set the location as enabled. Go to location. In this, give permission to our IoT device. I already set the permission, so it is showing over here. Then go to SMS, set the permission for this, like enable the permission. Okay, once this is done, open this application, paste your username and password, give login. Okay, now you enter into the system. Just open this application. That's it. Nothing is required more than that. SMS will, because you need to give the SMS permission on, as well as first SIM should be SMS SIM, and SMS balance should must be there into the application. So this is the thing. Once you switch on the application, now directly go to your hardware and work on it. I will show you how it is working. This is the hardware unit. Here we have a IoT module. Just connect this adapter, 12 volt 1 amps power adapter. Directly connect the adapter to this blue color knob. Then we have two bottle of waters. One is a salt water, this is a normal water. Both are RO waters, RO purified waters. So this is a normal water, this is a salt water. For a better view, I just place some less quantity of salt water, high quantity of normal water for differentiation, to show the differentiation. Then this is the water floating sensor, which identifies the water is there or not. If this is an indication of no water, if the sensor is raised, means automatically automatically it means the water is available into the tank. Then this is a pH sensor. You have to place the sensor into the water up to the level of this one. Don't go above to this, because this is a circuit unit. If it is touching to the water, automatically the sensor will be spoiling. So maximum level of water should be this much only. Don't go above to that. Be careful in it. If you place the sensor inside the water, this much level means the sensor will be spoiling. So let me see how it is working. Just connect the adapter into this port. Already we set the hotspot and open the application as well. Now our work is just switch on the adapter. Now this is an indication, red light. We need to check the hotspot is connected or not. Once the hotspot is connected, automatically remaining things will be done. Now I didn't place the water level sensor into water. Now you see the system. We have a URL over here. Once you place the URL into the web browser, automatically you have a login like this. Just use the same credential what I give for Wi-Fi connection, that means hotspot connection. Paste the same username and password, give login. You have this much options. Administrator contact number, you can enter the contact number of administrator. You can change to any number, no issues in it. First I clear all the server data. Previously entered server data, I cleared all the data. You have option for that. Now I go to view IoT summary. You can see present data is updated, like water flow status is empty. That means water flow status is nothing. pH level cannot be calculated until the status of water flow is there. So now we put the floating sensor into the water, then see how it is working. Just take this sensor, place into the water. Before to that, compulsorily this pH sensor should be presented into the water. See, the water level must be below to this knob. Then only your device will be safe. Otherwise your device will not be safe. Now see the pH meter reading is also working. See the website now. Automatically it is updating. Water flow found. Once the water flow found, then only the level of pH is calculated. Normal water. It is going now. Normal water. Like that. So you can see a number of values over here. Every 3 seconds it is updating. You can see the date and time as well as water flow status. Water flow status is nothing but the flow level sensor status, then pH level, then normal water ratio. Below 150, the level of water is normal. Above 150, the level of water is salt water. I mentioned like this. Now I change the pH sensor over here. I change the pH sensor only. Just mix the salt once again, then place it. Now we will see. See now, the level is 161, that means it goes to salt water range. Okay, it goes to salt water range. So this is the working of the kit. And one more thing, device location details. If you click the device location details, automatically your location is calculated over here. If you view locate on map, automatically it will goes to Google map area. Here there is a red color indication. If you click, double click on this, here it shows the address. So this is the entire working of the kit. Back. So this is the entire working of the kit. You can view the IoT summary, and if you want to reset the summary, means you can just reset it. You reset up, back, the IoT summary. Now it is empty. Now it is empty means the present data will be updating. You cannot do anything. Just leave the page as it is. Automatically the updation will be coming first. Last will be coming first. Okay. Now I change the salt water to normal water now. See this? Just raise it to normal water. Now see. Normal water. Website will be getting changed. It is a normal water. So this is a complete working of this kit. Three things you need to do. First thing is you need to change the hotspot settings. Second thing, you have to give permission to the installed IoT application, like location and SMS permission. Enable the SMS and location permission. Third thing, open the IoT application with the password and username of IoT2K19010. Open that. Once it is done, switch on the mobile location, GPS location, then open the application, enter the username and password, you log in. Once it is done, open the website with the username password I gave already. Open the website and log in. Once you log in, set the administrator number for SMS. Then you just go to the View IoT summary. You can view the present readings. Last will be coming first, so you can easily identify. If you want to see the device location details, which location it is there, you can see the location also. So this is the complete working of the kit. Thank you.